What happens when you take class participation out of the classroom? Okay. What happens when you challenge your student? You turn the classroom inside out and ask your students to be teachers. And what happens if, furthermore, you expand the reach of your classroom to include the global community? These are the questions we asked ourselves 6 months ago. And we have to admit, we had no idea what the answer would be, but we were curious. So to introduce myself, I am an adjunct professor, next slide, of electrical engineering here at the Cooper Union. I teach a bioelectricity course, ECE 434, and it's a really kind of, it's a very dense course where we discuss all of the electrical signals that go through the body. It's, you know, very serious, my very serious students. Okay, let me get out of the way. We learn about Galvani and Volta's experiments with frogs and antennas. We also learn lots and lots of equations. These are the Hodgkin-Huxley equations that explain like the generation and propagation of action potentials along the squid axon. We also learn about how you can manipulate those currents as well as measure those currents for lots of diagnostics. So they learn to read EKGs, EEGs, EMGs, all kinds of blank blank Gs, and they're amazing, right? But what we also did in this class was we extended the reach of what I could provide in the classroom and had seminars. Seminars hosted by the students and then seminars hosted by external speakers. And I've been doing this now for 5 years and every year it's grown. And so at this juncture, as a TED Fellow and now TED Senior Fellow, we thought, why not extend it even more? And you're wondering, oh, is that what we're part of? Is that this experiment that we're a part of sitting here? Yes. So we decided, let's open it up. Let's start by having each student lead a conversation. We were using some platforms on the TED.com website, specifically TED Conversations. And every week, we had two students lead a conversation with the TED Global community in which they took some of the material we learned in class and decided to extend it by analogy into some sort of broader question. And so, for example, my student, Sophie, asked, you know, we learned about the senses, we learned about chemoreceptors and mechanoreceptors and all these cells that generate the sensations that we experience in the body, and she asked, can we ever know how another person senses the world? Okay, and this was an amazing conversation. We had Simon, who also I believe is in the audience, who asked the question after we did a lot of simulations involving the Hodgkin-Huxley equations, which, as you know, you can imagine, are not like solvable on the back of a napkin. And he asked, how can computer models help us build intuition? Again, engaging with the broader community to answer and create a discussion that we never would have been able to have in class. We had Joanna, these are just examples. Joanna, who's also here, who noticed that, you know, we learned about nerves, we learned about senses, we learned about how those cells create action potentials that are propagated throughout the body to the brain, which interprets the signals. And she asked, you know, would you rather be an information producer like those cells that are producing the information, the sensation we experience? Would you rather be a propagator like the nerves that propagate those signals around the body? Or would you rather be an information consumer like the brain that processes it? I mean, I was so proud of the way that these students really extended the information we learned in the class and made it the launching pad for these broader conversations. And, you know, it resulted in some interesting results. So Andrew, who you met tonight, actually had some poetry that someone wrote for him. He'd be happy to read some of that to you, I'm sure, if you asked him. And even got a shout out from some of the people at TED. We you know, what were the results? Okay, so we got some poetry, but we also had some amazing statistics. Over 70,000 page views in 60 countries, reaching over 1 million people via Facebook shares. And it's starting to catch on now in the broader community. This was a posting from this morning, actually, where a person in the broader TED community said, oh, by the way, I saw this amazing conversation on kitchen scientists. And, you know, it motivated her to take some steps in her life. You know, clap, clap, clap. We're so happy and thrilled with how this is going. But, you know, as a researcher, I cannot help but say this is an N of one. Okay, this was an experiment we did once. And, you know, we'd love to see how this kind of idea can really be propagated in the broader world. And so as a scientist, as a researcher, as an educator, I ask, you know, what can we learn by teaching? And what can be taught to us about learning along the way? So thank you.